Wanted to start a scrapbook layout. I love mixed media, so I'm also using mixed media on a scrap page. First of all, let me put on some gesso. There's something in here. I'm using the clear one because some of the white is another white than the page itself. It's a bit cluttered. No problem. We do it like this. And then just with a silicone brush, not brush, spatula from the kitchen, I'm going to just rub it all over the page. Missed a spot here, I think. I'm going to use a lot of wet medium, so that is why I'm putting gesso on, so it doesn't soak into the pages right away. We can let that dry. Maybe I should have it some with a heat gun. You could let it dry, but I'm impatient, so I'm not doing that. I'm going to use oxided distress ink. I love the matte finish of it. And did you already see the new color of Tim Holtz, Speckled Egg? Love that color. Need it very badly. But today I'm going to stick with pink, reds and oranges. I don't have all the colors yet, but I can play with what I have. What I'm using is wild honey from the oxides. Give it a good shake so you hear the bone. Everything is mixed very good. I have an acrylic block for my stems. I'm putting some dots on it. Add a bit of water. Already some splatter here, no problem. Push it down, pull it back up. If you want to, you can take a brush and put it out some more to lighten the dark areas. Then I'm going to pick worn lipstick. Also a good shake. Same technique. Put some on the acrylic block. A bit of water. Another splatter here. Dripping, doesn't matter. The background will be covered with a photo, so you don't see the whole thing. You can also do this with some thin plastic packaging, but I don't have any with me right now, so I'm going to use the acrylic block. Also a good shake. This one is candied apple. a bit of water. Don't like harsh lines. I'm going to make it a bit more of a flow here. Not waiting for it to dry again. Putting the heat gun on it. Excuse me. I'm a bit impatient, I must admit. Also drying on the back. It's also wet here, so I'm taking it off. Dry enough, I think. Then I will be using the new Distress Grit paste. This is opaque. We also have crackle and a lot of other stuff. Let me grab my palette knife. And now let me see. I always like this. Put them on a ring so they are all together. This is a Christmas one, not getting it. The hearts I like. This one I like. Oh, this is also nice. Decisions. Maybe I will use a few, not just one. Let me start with this one. As you see, I'm not so good at cleaning my stencils. Don't have to be that precise. I like it when it's a bit shabby. I don't clean my stencils if I'm using paint or sprays, but you need to clean them up right now if you use grit paste, otherwise it will get stuck in all the small holes. And then your stencil is not how it's supposed to be. I think I'm also using this one because a bit of heart here. And I like hearts. tiny bit more, I think, here. Again, cleaning my stencil off grandma. To keeping them a bit neat. And the grid paste is everywhere. Also, I will give this a quick dry. As you can see, the grit paste is picking up some of the color of the oxide. It's no problem. I like when it comes together. That is good for now. Now for some mark making. I'm searching through my Tim Hortons stamps. I'm taking the Marble and Dolly, this one, not using the whole stamp as it is, just making some marks with part of it. That's why I don't use an acrylic block right now. I'm just using my hands. So it's not a big square on the page, but just small part which I'm putting down on it and pushing on it. As you can see, not all harsh black, but putting it down again and again so it fades. Let me see. I need to grab a black pen. Before I put any more mixed media down, I'm putting down a black line. On all four sides. Bit of a board. It doesn't have to be neat, but I like it. I think it makes it more cohesive. Oops, throwing everything down. Some marks, just random, not thinking about it. And I think I want to use this picture of my daughter. She's now 14, but she was so little. I think it's really nice, but I don't know if I want it on this grunge paper, or that I'm going to get some design papers. Let me see, just a second. Getting there. Yeah, we start with this one. Let me grab some sticky tape. Oh, a bit more careful. Of course, you can cut it neatly, or you can tear it. After about 30 years of crafting, I'm not very good at straight cutting. I don't know how that can happen, but I must see if I can do it this time. Not really, but it doesn't have to be perfect for me. The paper I'm using is from Carousel, Maggie Holmes, great paper. Just tearing this down. Bit too big. Just putting it down with one piece of sticky tape. And if I want to, I can glue, add more glue or adhesive. It's more towards the end, because now I can remove stuff if I need to. Let me see how this works. Me a bit more off here. Taking a bit off at the bottom because I think it's too heavy black. That's nice. Oh, that is why not too much tape. I will put it down as I go. Now, from some extras, I'm using again the oxided ink. And now I will grab a brush and dip it in some water. So I can pick up the oxide and give it some more of a splatter. I should wear an apron because the ink is getting really everywhere. A bit more water. And a quick dry. Also using some Heidi Shine for some gold splatters. Sorry for the noise. Now I have to get the bottle open. It's a bit stuck. A bit of gold never hurt anyone. Big splatter there. Again, sorry for the noise. The heat tool. I'm dabbing some on the kitchen towel, paper towel, I don't know how you call it, so it dries quicker. Thinking about, I grabbed a dolly from my stash. Let me see if this works. Oh no. Maybe on this side. Just for some extra dimension. Stick it down. Yeah, like it. Here. Now I'm going to grab some stickers. I'm a sucker for stickers. I have so many. This was at a children's show, a musical group that's called K3. And she knew all the songs by heart. Let me see. Some letters are always gone. I want to put Dance 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 on it. So I'm just checking. Yes. I think these are American Craft letters. Starting backwards, so I don't come into the picture too much. I'm not the one for measuring out where I'm going to put the letters. Don't care if it's a bit crooked. Let me see if I have another pack. Oh, I can use this one also. Also American Crafts Shine On stickers. Let me see. Not coming off right. Let me see if I can peel them off. Oh yeah, here it is. Oh, see a bit of the paper attached. She loved dancing, she loved all the songs, she knew them by heart, also the dances. And she went to a concert with my mother. And never stopped dancing. I think I want some black letters for the last dance. If I have them, I'm missing an E on this one. Let me see if I have more black stickers in my stash. Don't want the flat ones. Happening here. Sorry for the wait. I'm really trying to find me some good letters. I I really want black. I have some black. Okay. Want to try something? Let me grab a pair of small scissors. I'm going to cut this from the L. Then I'm going to put the F here. Not putting it on the black. And then grabbing well, maybe this will work. Something, oh, the ring of my stencils. So I made the E. I was missing the E. Maybe I think this is Amy Tangerine, what I'm getting right now. I like the word cherish. Don't know which line it was from. I don't know if it's. Let me cut it off. If I can see if I like it or not. No, it's too big, I think. It's too harsh. I already have the enormous glittering letters. So, maybe only some journaling. Let me grab a pen. For journaling, I always use this Sharpie Fine. And white. Maybe I should include the word cherish. Just a small bit of journaling. Really like this picture. And really like how it turned out with the little letters. I'm missing something, but I don't know really what. So maybe I will put some labels down. Or some die cuts. I don't know yet, but for now this is the finished product. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.